wanted to share some insights that we've seen from our work in the marketplace. So our topic today is around backing up work in progress to the cloud. Again, my name is John Feingold. I'm Chief Marketing Officer here at Signiant. So just to set some context, Signiant is well known across the industry for our ability to move very large files very quickly over any IP network between any type of storage. And so our software literally moves petabytes of content every day between people, between systems, and more to and from the cloud using our proprietary acceleration technology. We have a huge global footprint, so over a million users on the platform today, connecting more than 50,000 businesses. We're in pretty much every country in the world. And again, moving all types of video files and metadata across the globe. So through that work, you know, we work with all sorts of media companies of all sizes, all up and down the value chain, but have a lot of work with the production and post-production community. And through those interactions, we heard quite a few interesting tales around the topic of backup and disaster recovery. So Signiant software is used, again, any time files are moved across the media supply chain. But in this particular instance, we're going to talk about this specific use case, which is the backup of work in progress to the cloud. Because we were shocked to learn about some of the companies that were doing a pretty poor job in this area of backing up their work in progress. And given the high value of work in post-production, it was pretty shocking to see how few companies were doing it. So from our survey of hundreds of post houses, we found that only half are actually have systems in place to back up their work in progress on a nightly basis. And again, given the high value of work here, that was pretty surprising. Another thing we asked was just about the use of cloud storage, and certainly in media, cloud economics don't work for all use cases, and most media companies are not moving all of their assets into the cloud. Many are employing a hybrid strategy with some content on-prem and some in cloud storage, some across multiple cloud providers. But it was interesting that in 2021, 60% aren't using cloud storage at all. And again, some of that is, I'm sure, due to economics. Some of it may be due to just availability of the right expertise. But certainly in this particular area, we're talking about backup and disaster recovery, cloud storage can be a great ally. So we were surprised to learn that as well. The third data point up here, which is interesting, now this varied widely depending on the type of work being done and the size of company. But just to sort of set some context, on average, the post houses that responded reported that losing a day's work, a single day's work, would be about $33,000. And again, this varied widely. Of course, you know, high-end VFX work might be, you know, even much more than that. So there was quite a bit of variance, again, on size and type of work. But it just sort of sets the stage in terms of how alarming that is. Imagine if you were only backing up weekly, or if you didn't have any automated backup system in place, or were relying on your creative end users to do it themselves. The exposure that you have, you know, could eventually bankrupt or really harm a company if you lost, if you lost even a day's work, if not more. And I think the reason, you know, that we're seeing that is, you know, historically these automated backup systems and even, you know, cloud technology could be expensive and complex for a lot of businesses, but that's changing. So there's a lot of, you know, a lot of good news on the horizon in this area. We also collected a lot of quotes, but one of them that jumped out was we had a company that we talked to that lost their RAID storage and lost 2 weeks of work from a storage outage. And so you can imagine, you know, if 33K is the average over for a single day, that across 2 weeks, you know, you're talking about hundreds of thousands of dollars, you know, and that could be really crippling. We also asked just about how much data volume per day that companies are working with. And so again, varied widely depending on size of company and type of work, but many companies, you know, dealing with more than a terabyte every day, you know, most companies in that sort of hundreds of gigabytes or more. So we're talking about a massive amount of data. you know, and files, of course, are only getting bigger, and data sets more complex. And so that that's something that's continuing to trend in the direction of, you know, more and more costs, more and more complexity. So I think that's another reason why we're seeing, you know, companies not able to do this on a nightly basis. It's just a tremendous amount of data, and that creates challenges. On the plus side, what we are seeing, I wish I had a time series of this to show kind of the trend, because we're certainly seeing this through our lens at Signiant. But the good news is that a lot of companies are investing heavily in their network infrastructure to accommodate these larger files and these more complex workflows. And so, you know, as you can see here, lots of companies reporting now having networks of, you know, gigabit per second speeds or more. Many, you know, certainly most were well 100 megabits per second or higher, some still on the slower side. But lots of companies now at least having the physical network infrastructure in place to accommodate moving these large data sets. And now they just need the right software to make it easy to take advantage of all that network capability. Sorry, my slides are jumping around here. So with that, I want to talk about kind of the combination of a Signiant product called Jet and, of course, Amazon Web Services. You know, Signiant software works with all storage types and works across multiple, you know, the big three public cloud providers. But in this case, I want to talk about Amazon and Jet working together. So Jet is a SaaS product that makes it super easy to move any size data set between any type of storage in an automated fashion, connects to your on-prem storage, connects easily to your S3 buckets, and can move any size data set over any IP network using Signiant's proprietary acceleration technology. And with Amazon, you know, I mentioned before, you know, one of the challenges with cloud adoption has been economics, right? Which just aren't always favorable for all workflows, certainly in media where you're dealing with these massive data sets. But with backing up, you know, work in progress, cloud and specifically Amazon and some of the tools they offer can be a perfect ally, because you don't need to keep your work in progress forever if you were, you know, compounding those, you know, hundreds of gigabytes or terabytes of storage. And not expiring out that data, it would certainly rack up a pretty significant bill. But lots of companies we talk to are, you know, aging out their WIP, you know, after 7 or 10 days. And of course, you're only egressing it in the case of a disaster, you know, so you're not moving it in and out of storage, which can also rack up some pretty expensive cost. So in the case of backing up work in progress to the cloud, you can use Amazon has introduced a bunch of policy controls to make it easy to expire content. So if you want to, you know, age it out after 7 days, or you even wanted to move it off to Glacier, which is their cheaper tier of storage, they make it very easy to set up those policy controls. And then with Jet, you can control the timing and frequency of those backups. So if you just want to, you know, have it run only at night when everyone's out of the office, or do it, you know, on a certain interval or anything like that, Jet gives you the flexibility to move it when you want to move it. And Amazon gives you the flexibility to easily age it out. And so the two work hand in hand very well to keep it simple to use and extremely cost effective. So Jet, you know, again, just to reiterate, it's, you know, built on Signiant's core acceleration technology. It employs our fastest transport yet, capable of multiple gigabits per second speeds, taking advantage of all that physical infrastructure that I mentioned. As companies are increasing their networks, the faster the fatter the pipe, the more Signiant Jet can help. But we're seeing some blazing speeds now with on these newer networks. There's no file size limit. So, you know, when you're dealing with those terabyte data sets, or even in VFX work where you might be dealing with frame by frame formats, folders with millions of files, there's no limits on the amount, the file sizes or the number of files. Jet has something called checkpoint restart. So if there is a network interruption, it will automatically restart the transfer at the point of failure and continue it without you having to do anything. It keeps you informed through alerts and a visual dashboard, so you can always see what's going on in real time or get alerted if something does go wrong. And then provides all sorts of flexibility. So as I mentioned, you can schedule those jobs to happen, you know, just at night. It can be hot folder workflows, so that anytime a new file is added, it's automatically moved off site. Or you can even trigger it with a manual send it now operation if you want to control it more granularly. And then of course there's APIs to integrate JET and with other systems if you wanted to control it based on some more sophisticated logic. But it makes it really easy to control the how frequently and what time those backup jobs occur. And then of course security is always at the top of everyone's mind. And so you know, Cygnion is our investment in enterprise grade security. You know, makes us so we're trusted by the studios, broadcasters, and most of the major media companies in the world rely on Cygnion technology. And so we obviously put security at the you know, at the top of our priority stack with all of our products. And again, ease of use is one of, you know, is one of the limiting factors in terms of companies. You know, one of the reasons that they weren't backing up their work nightly. So, you know, with JET and AWS, it's super simple. You know, we can have you up and running in a day. First thing is just to connect your on-prem storage to the Cygnion cloud. So you can install a very simple piece of Linux or Windows software and connect that to your storage locally on-prem, any type of storage. Then you set up your S3 bucket, which of course is, you know, takes minutes to do on Amazon. Set up those policies that I mentioned to age out the content, either move it off to Glacier or expire it out after a period of time. And then set up your JET jobs to say exactly when and how frequently you want to move the content. So for a backup job, again, you might do it, you know, after 7 p.m. at night when everyone's out of the office to keep your network free during the workday. And then once it's up and running, it just runs in the background. So you never have to think about it. It will keep you informed. If something does go wrong, you'll get alerts. You can get confirmations when jobs are complete. And of course, you can log into the dashboard from anywhere, anytime, and get real-time updates on exactly what's going on in the system. So the goal there is just keep it super simple, you know, set it and forget it, let it run in the background, and always be assured that your content is backed up and done so in the manner that that aligns with your business needs. So again, learned from this, you know, from our interactions with our audience and through this survey that there was just a lot of gaps in people protecting their work, but wanted to, you know, use this opportunity to let people know that the, you know, cloud tools and cloud technology have evolved in such a way that it's really accessible to any size business. It's super easy to manage and get set up, and will protect you from those potential disasters. And so we certainly encourage everyone to take advantage of the modern technology to keep, you know, keep their work secure and safe. So with that, just want to, you know, like I said, I'll keep it quick, but thank you and open to questions. If you do want more information, you can go to cygnion.com/backup and download a data sheet. Or again, my name is John Feingold, and you can reach me at jfeingold@cygnion.com. Glad to answer any questions.